Ed?
After all that, my comments are going to be significantly more boring. March is one of our off-season months and is typically a quiet month, and the financials should reflect that, and they do. Basically, we went through the month of March on plan. The various spending programs is what normally happens there are on track. Good news is the advanced reservations that we're seeing actually are positive. They're not revenue as yet, but they are unearned income that I think bodes well for the upcoming season. Looking at the specifics, the balance sheets year-to-date, fiscal year-to-date, are in good shape. They reflect the strong season we had during July to October. Quite right now, cash is up, equity is up in all categories. The commission balance sheet is particularly strong compared to where it was last year, in that the CTO has come to the rescue and has essentially subsidized it. This particular fiscal year is not getting the additional support that we're going to enjoy next year, next fiscal year, from the two legislatures. So it'll have a negative impact on the overall CTO NOI. However, the commission will be supported, and we'll be meeting our obligations there. Going into the next fiscal year, though, with the good news we got out of the legislative sessions, we're going to have a fully funded commission for probably the first time ever. I went back looking for when the full support had been there from both sides, and it was beyond the records I had access to. So the commission P&L next year, for the first time probably forever, is actually going to be quite strong. So what it does is it enables the CTO to continue to grow in its plan to support the eventual self-sufficiency and keep us on track to make that achievement possible, so that as we get past the next 3 or 4 years, where we'll continue to ask for support from the states, we'll be in a position at the end of that to really pretty much solo on our own, with the exception of getting legislative support for running the commission. So things are looking pretty positive there. Specifically, we're looking at an NOI, even in spite of the fact that we're going to be subsidizing the commission of somewhere in the order of $350,000 to $400,000, which is still a pretty good achievement in terms of operating the business for the fiscal year. Capital spending is about on plan. It's about $250,000 for the month of March. That's about what we would anticipate during that period. So we're having a good winter season in terms of achieving some of our capital goals as well. Any questions that I would entertain?
Just a comment. We know that the financials aren't photogenic, but none of this would be happening without good financial management, because our operation would not be running, there would not be 168 locomotive, there would not be the historic car fleet. So congratulations to you and the team for making sure that the finances are in good order. So congratulations, John and Ed and everybody else.
Well, I would like to comment that Ed has taken the role of chief financial officer. He's taken the bit in his teeth, and I think he's doing a remarkable job. I think the rest of the commission, I know I feel much more confident in the numbers that we see and in being able to understand the picture. I agree that it doesn't seem like a very romantic job to do the green eyeshade work. But I would say that while we tend to think that railroads run on water and coal and steam, they actually run on dollars. And without the dollars, they don't run. So my hat's off to you for taking on the job and for the job you're doing.
And I'd like to second that too. Yeah. From my perspective, I'm so glad that I have the confidence that I do in Ed to be overseeing this part of our operation, because the competence and the background, I think, as I said, gives me a greater confidence than than I could even express. So I thank you personally as well as my commissioner hat.
Well, Ed, I'll jump in here. I noted that you said that the financials were pretty positive in your usual conservative way. I'll ask you to reflect on the fact that this railroad is nearing its 50th birthday, and for about the first 45 years of that, there was a big question as to whether it would survive. So much has changed, so much relative to our history is now so bright, so rosy, so absolutely positive, not just pretty positive, but thank you for being pretty positive.
Well, it's certainly nice to hear the kind words, and I appreciate your sentiment, but I would also counter and say that the reality is that being up here to be the spokesperson for the financial side of it really is only a reflection of the work that gets done in the trenches, on the tracks, in the offices, and that we always need to remind ourselves that our purposes in the leadership role is really to support these people and remember that we actually work for them. The success of this place doesn't happen without them being successful. And,
amen.
That's, I think, where my emphasis will continue to be. So,
thank you.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. We can do it right now.
It's up to you, Mr.
Chair. Let's do that.
Chair.
Okay. Betsy, you're not on the agenda for some reason, but now you are.